السلام عليكم.
Should we try again?
Yes.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. One final time. Loud enough for me to get up. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Alhamdulillah, you're here with us. Good. What day of Ramadan is it tonight? 24? Some of the Turks are looking at me and saying, no, it's 25, Ramadan. Yes, we know the Turks, they started the day before. First and foremost, assalamu alaikum and welcome to Open Iftar London. It's a true honor and privilege to have you all here with us on a Saturday evening. Thank you for coming. We always ask this question every evening, so we'll ask the question and we'll see what the response is like. How many of you are here at Open Iftar London for the first time? Show of hands, please. Keep them really high up in the air, right? You see? How many of you here? Keep your hands up. You're here for the first time since our inception. Since 2013. Okay? Now have a look around. Look at how many of you here are here at Open Iftar London for the first time. That's absolutely amazing. Give yourselves a massive round of applause. Welcome to the RTP family, welcome to Open Iftar. We're thrilled to have you here with us, and we hope this is not the last time you'll be able to join us as well for the very few nights we have left of Ramadan. I'm really honored to be introducing our next guest speaker tonight. This is someone who has completely transformed the way not only Muslims, but the charity sector in its emergency appeals and its aid efforts, and particularly in institutionalizing a school of charity, of volunteering, and of community spirit in this country. And in the early noughties, Dr. Henia Benna was awarded an OBE by Queen Elizabeth for acknowledging the amazing work and service he has done for this country in the third sector. And his experience crosses over 30 years, maybe over 40 years of his involvement in disaster and emergency relief, locally, internationally, nationally. He travels more than any person I can imagine. He travels more than most world leaders. Tonight, Dr. Henny traveled all the way from Dhaka, from Bangladesh, to be with us this evening. So he traveled last night, 11 p.m. local time, to travel here, stop over in Istanbul for a couple of hours, actually join us here in London before then he goes back to Birmingham. So he's someone who is constantly at the service of his community, and he is a leader. He is a leader, he's a teacher, and I'm very, very proud to say that I am a student of him. And to have him here share his wisdom with us is truly humbling. So I'm going to introduce Dr. Henny, and we're almost back into his time. And I just want to, for those who know, Dr. Henny Benna is the founder of Islamic Relief UK, then went on to work on the Muslim Charities Forum, which was a conglomerate of various charities coming together under the wing of the MCF, working together, and also the Humanitarian Forum, which I had the privilege of working with Dr. Henny on very, very closely, and ultimately working on capacity building and reaching out to women and to youth in particular in developing countries. So, guys, without further ado, I want you all to join me in giving an absolute massive Open Iftar London welcome to our guest speaker tonight, Dr. Henny Benna.
Alhamdulillah, is it working? Alhamdulillah, wa sallam ala rasulillah. I'm very honored to be with you tonight. It is something that I was waiting for, to be inspired by you, as I've been talking to the volunteers earlier on. We're here to be inspired. who are here to feel the community reunion together from different background, different culture, different religion at the middle of London. It's a great culture of London that we are enjoying, and we hope people globally will have the same culture together. Omar was saying that today is 24th or 25th of Ramadan, and sometimes people as Muslims think that we are looking for the night of power. Night of power is not only in Ramadan. Night of power is every night in the year. When we work for community, when we serve community, when we be with the poor, when we be with the displaced, with the refugees, with the sick, with the elderly, with the widow, with the orphans, this is the night of power. It's not only the last 10 days of Ramadan. Every night in the year, we can change it to become the night of power. Don't limit yourself to the last odd days of Ramadan only. Every day in the life, in your life, is a night of compassion, is a night of mercy, is a night of tranquility, is a night of responding and caring and sharing with everybody. Ramadan is a spirit, not only for Muslims. It's for the Muslims to gel together with everybody, with every community, even to pray for their enemies, that God will guide them, and to pray for themselves, that God also guide them. Don't keep looking at the night of power only and cry for Allah tonight or tomorrow and after Ramadan is over. No. Work. Work, work. It's not a dua or supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not enough. You come and tell me I'm going to stand up the night, tonight or tomorrow to make dua. But who is going to do the action? Action is where Allah responds to you. Then after that, you can make the dua. We cannot change community, society, humanity, unless we act. Dua is not enough. Our fasting is good for us, but has to be translated to community action. Our prayer is good enough, but not good enough. It has to be translated into community action. Our iman or faith could be good, but not good enough. It has to become a community action to build the community. We have to translate everything in our iman, in our prayer, in our fasting into community action. Not just saying, tonight is the night of power. I stand in the mosque the whole night to cry, to listen to the Quran, and after that's nothing. No way. No way. No, we have to act. We have to act, we have to act. Action is what Allah wants from us, whether we are Muslims or non-Muslims. Show your Islam in the good manner. Show our Islam in the good manner. Show our Islam in the caring and sharing. The people who are actually supporting the Prophet ﷺ at the very beginning of Islam, when he came from a Taif, and he was stoned by the children there, and his feet was bleeding, was a non-Muslim, atheist, mushrik. His name was Al-Mut'am ibn Adi. Prophet ﷺ, when he came to Mecca, he asked Al-Mut'am to give him protection when he came in, and he did. Mut'am died as a non-Muslim. Then when Prophet ﷺ immigrated from Mecca to Medina, at the time of the battlefield of Badr, when Muslims became victorious, and there was a lot of prisoners of war at that time, he declared, he made a statement to remember whom? The one who made a favor to him who was not a Muslim, Al-Mut'am. And he said, if Al-Mut'am is amongst us, I will ask him to give me my opinion how to do with the prisoners of war at that time. In a respect, from the very beginning, Prophet ﷺ was a community worker. bringing every individual in the community to be a part of the community. No isolation, no separation, no isms, no different schools of thought which divide us on the basis of ignorance. The more our ulama become ignorant, the more division will become, divided we become. The more our ulama become ignorant, the more divided we become. So when we look at Ramadan, when we look at the last 10 days of Ramadan, we look at our life is Ramadan. Our life is a night of power. That's how can we change ourselves internally so we'll be able to change the community around us. Maybe brother was talking about my arriving today from Bangladesh. I was in a place called Cook's Bazar, visiting some Rohingya refugees. The Rohingya are not called by the host government as refugees. And they are not called by the government which throw them out as citizens. Who are they? Nobody knows. A million people. And this is the big ask. And this is a big action. A million people living in a very overcrowded camps. Less resources. Less facilities. For a reason they don't know. Well, we call it ethnic cleansing. Could be. We call it whatever you call it. People politically, they call them any name. But at the end of the day, they are human beings. This is one of the forgotten crises affecting minorities living in countries. 1 million people living in a very overcrowded camps in Cox's Bazar and the surrounding area. This is one thing. In Greece, we have 80,000 people, the boat people, are living in a very difficult situation. Children at the age of 3 or 4 or 5 are being raped in the middle of Europe. Do we know about them? Have we visited the camps in Greece to understand the people, the boat people, who are actually traveling from Iraq, from Africa, from Syria, from everywhere, to find the way for their life, for the loved one, and a lot of them are dead in the sea? This is another forgotten crisis. Ramadan is about remembering the minorities. The Eritrean people who are living in East of Sudan, 500,000 for the last 50 years as refugees. Do we know about them? No, we don't. We are here in the middle of London. Quite often do not realize that suffering is going on and on and on globally. We don't want to become such an individual who only cares about himself or herself. And this is the spirit of Ramadan that we want you, as Muslims and the Christians, to bring back to the community. Jesus, when he came, you know why they call him the Messiah? Because he was sweeping the land to spread the message of a God. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Masih. Yamzah al-ard mas'han lika yanshir da'wat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fil ard. That's why you call him in Arabic Messiah, Al-Masih, alayhi salam. He came to do this. We are the follower of Jesus, peace be upon him, as a Muslim. Very proud to be following Jesus, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the message of Jesus. This is the message of Muhammad. This is the message of Moses. Community. Community, community. Working together, helping one another. Don't let anybody politically to divide us. They divide us, to fragment us, to rule us, which is wrong. You are educated. And I believe in each and every one of you. Please, 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 do not let anyone to divide you. No matter what. And make yourself busy of becoming a servant to the community. No matter who are the community is, who is inside the community, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims. Be as a servant. Whether you are Hindu or Sikh or Muslim or Christian or Jew or whatever it is, be as a servant. The one who become a servant is the one who will be elevated before God. The one who does not become or become, he will not be able to become a servant, he will never be elevated to the high ranks of God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this message is the message of Ramadan for all of us. I was in Somalia as well before Cox's Bazar and Bangladesh. I went to Somalia for a few days, then went to from Mogadishu to Hargeisa and back because of the Somali sisters and brothers here. You know where I have been. It is a country which is in catch 22. Let a nation to be depending on the dependency syndrome. We don't want you as youngsters to only give money for food. We want you to give money to enable people, to empower people, to let them to build their own community. Build a community, not feed a community. The woman in Bangladesh, from Bihar in India, what they want? $200 to start a project. $200, which is 140 or 150 pounds, to start a project, to earn income. Same for Somalia. Same for everywhere. Stop spending money on feeding. Make your donation for development. Development, development. It's number one. When we rise high in our understanding of the humanitarian sector, talk about advocacy. The rights of the people to exist. The rights of the people to have job. The rights of the people to have peace in the society. The rights of the people to be protected. It's advocacy, higher. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. وَتَعْمُونَ لَا مش رَيْتَ لَذِي يُكَذِّبُ الدِّينِ فَذَلِكَ الَّذِي يَدُعُ الْيَتِيمُ وَلَا يَحُدُّ. The word had in Quran, رَيْتَ لَذِي يُكَذِّبُ الدِّينِ. Have you seen the one who denied the day of judgment? Who is he? Is the one who treat the orphan badly. It's one side. And the one who does not advocate for the needs of the needy. If we do not advocate, we do not advocate for the needs of the needy, that means that we are actually nukadhib bid-deen. Right, الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين. Advocacy is a part of Islam. Spend money on it. To stand up and fight for the rights of people. It's not only food. It's not only shelter. It's not only clothes. Advocacy, research, development. Don't let any donor to create the dependency syndrome in the camps. Unfortunately, we are extremely good to respond when the disaster happening. But we do not prevent the disaster. We do not educate people to stand up on their feet. But I'm saying $200 for a family and an income generation project in Bangladesh and anywhere else. And this is the ask. I'm not fundraising from you, by the way. No way. I stopped doing this 10, 15 years ago. But now we have to raise the issue. We have to build community. We have to build you as youth to become the future leaders, not only of your community, but of humanity. I'm very inspired. I'm not tired, to be very honest. I'm extremely fresh. I can talk till tomorrow, if you want. But no. You know why? Because your spirit is inspiring me. Because the way you look at me gave me a hope that I can go on for the coming 50 years again. And you can meet here after 50 years when we have iftari and we ask you the same question. How many people here amongst you are for the first time? Can we meet here after 50 years? Yes? With your children? With your grandchildren? And I'll be here. I will be waiting for you. So this is my talk to you today. Don't let Ramadan to be a few days. Ramadan is a life mission for Muslims and for non-Muslims. Show your goodness to your neighbor in Ramadan and after Ramadan. In action. In action. In action. Caring, sharing, and delivering community building. Fight the people who want to divide us. Stop them. Don't allow them to fragment our society, our community, our country, and even our religion. This mosque, this sheikh, no way. Ignorance is division. Knowledge is reunion. Jazakum Allah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Happy Ramadan, inshallah. خلاص. There's food. Food food will be coming. يلا يلا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله.